giving me the opportunity. It's not like I wrote a 3-page speech or anything. But, wow. Oh, it's my first word. Wow. I started writing this out months ago, and honestly, I couldn't figure out a better way to start this than with a gigantic thank you. Thank you for allowing me to represent you this past year. Thank you for being my support when I needed it, and knowing how to always keep me smiling. Because of you, I have been able to grow into an amazing person, someone who I wish I had to look up to when I was growing up. Being a title holder was a lot different than I expected. After trying 2 times previously before being awarded this title, I thought I would have some semblance of an idea of what this job was. If anything I learned within the first week, there is no way to prepare for the level of dedication, growth, and strength you both exude and witness as a title holder. I have gone to birthday parties, classrooms, fundraisers, meetings, and more with a crown on my head, and each area has people that view me differently. I am a princess from a fairy tale, a young college graduate, Miss America, and even simply, Miss Jackson. Over 100 appearances in the span of 1 year, from speaking at leadership conferences to hearing kindergartners sing to me, I have had an amazing time as Miss Whatcom County. More importantly, though, I learned a lot about myself. I learned that it's okay to not be the perfect queen, because that isn't what the Miss America organization is about. It's fine that I list Wonder Woman as one of my personal heroes. If you've been following me on Instagram, you see that I have a lot of pictures with Wonder Woman. And the fact that I have been coding since I was young is a wonderful attractor for getting young women interested in computer science. Being who I am right now is enough. I was asked once in a mock interview years ago what I would like my legacy to be. And I had replied, I wanted to be remembered by those who I have helped. That still rings true today. The future presidents, supreme justices, football players, movie stars, engineers, and astronauts that I have met, I want to be remembered by the good work that they do for their community. That is the crux of what my platform is. It's an investment. It takes time. But the end result is something that is so much bigger than ourselves. This year could not have been possible, though, without the love and support of many. First, I have to thank God, because none of this would have been possible without him. I have been blessed with this opportunity, and I'm so thankful for his goodness. He has a wonderful plan for me, and I can't wait to see what's to come. To Mom, I honestly have no idea what I would have done this year without you. Thank you for being my voice of reason when my perfectionist came out, and for being such a stronghold for me whenever my life would seem crazy. You are my best friend, and I'm lucky to have such a strong woman as my mother. Thank you for always being my example of what a true leader looks like. Daddy, no matter how big the audience or how loud the music is, I know that I will be able to hear you wherever you are out of the crowd.
That's my girl!
It's on the Miss Washington DVD. I can hear it clear as a bell. But thank you for being my cheerleader and for constantly reminding me that I am just fine the way I am. Your service in the Army may be over, but you are still my Army dad, my hero when I need you. Thank you both for teaching me how to always look at the big picture and to help others. I love you. I wasn't kidding about this 3-page thing. To Chris, who could not be here tonight. My not so little anymore brother. I can't express how proud I am of you. Through your many trials, you have become such a resilient and strong man of God and have become an accomplished tennis player. Thank you for always knowing exactly what to say to me right when I needed to hear it, and for giving me hugs, even though it may not be so cool to do that anymore. Love you, Chris. Thank you for your support. To my Miss Whatcom County sisters, the sisterhood of this program is out of this world, and I am grateful to the countless memories I have gained from my older sisters. From mock interviews to one-on-one talks and surprise birthday dinners, you have been instrumental in helping me grow this year. Thank you for your belief in me and love. My Miss Washington sisters, wow, we have had an experience, we've experienced so much together. The week we spent together was such a growing experience for me, and I'm thankful for the friendships I have made with each and every one of you. I love you all so much, and I'm grateful to know that no matter where I go in the state, I will have a friend. To Connie, you are my soul sister for life, and I love you. I can never not smile when I see you, And I owe at least half of my outbursts of laughter and awkward times to something you have texted me. To Sergey and Mary, I am confident in my own skin because of the two of you. Mary, thank you for helping me not be afraid of the weight room and for getting me obsessed with deadlifting. And thank you, Sergey, for just amplifying my love for the gym tenfold. You have constantly pushed me and encouraged me to a point where I feel like I could lift 500 pounds. For now, I will settle for 225. Patty, Mama Duck, as soon as I stepped off the stage for talent at Miss Washington, you were waiting to give me the biggest and most necessary hug I needed. Thank you for being there for all of us title holders, both during and after Miss Washington, and for giving the best advice. Peggy and Mike Miller, couldn't forget you guys. Thank you for your selfless acts of love and kindness that you have poured into all of us in the Miss Washington system. We are all successful because of your dedication to this program, and I'm honored that I get to be a part of your family. To my best friends, thank you for being at all my pageants and for sticking with me through this whole journey. Whether I have the crown or not, you all make me feel like a queen. I love you, crazies. And finally, to Carol, you are my second mom, hands down. From topless drives to Spokane, late night talks, feeding me when I had no food, and always ready to encourage me when I felt like I couldn't go any further. I honestly couldn't express my gratitude in having you as my director. For 3 years, you've been telling me who I am is all I need to be a title holder. It just took me this year to finally believe you. Love you, Mom Instructor. To the class of 2015, and my soon-to-be little sister, live in this moment. Enjoy every day that you have this job. It goes by so quickly, you hardly realize that time has passed. Take this time to truly further your platform in this community, but also take it as an opportunity to get a grasp of yourself. This position is a vulnerable one, and it is the perfect chance for you to stretch and grow into the person you have the potential to be. Thank you, Whatcom, for these amazing past few years, and for honoring me with this title for the past 364 days. But who's counting? In the words of Walt Disney, all dreams can come true if you have the courage to pursue them. Forever your Miss Whatcom County 2014, Lizzie Jackson.
Thank you.